Hello friends, welcome to our English class. Children, yesterday I told you about our first poem, Wake Up, written by C. Fletcher. Okay, in this poem, the poet wants to tell to these children that they have to wake up early in the morning and what they have to see. See children, again I am going to tell you the explanation of the whole poem. So just listen it carefully. The poet is asking the children to wake up and enjoy the beautiful day. They must get up and go out to play and enjoy the sound of birds chirping on the trees and bees buzzing in the garden. Again, the poet is asking the lazy children to get up and go out to play. The importance of time is also shown as the poet says that it is too late to sleep now. The sleepy children have to be punctual and must wake up early in the morning. And children, in the last stanza, the poet wants to tell that children must take a bath, dress up for the day, eat a good breakfast and go to school, just like everyone else is doing his or her daily chores. All the animals in the farms, like cows, horses, ducks, sheep, and even the tiniest chicken, are wake up. One can hear the sound of chicken chip, chip, chip. It was an indication for every creature to get up and get started for the day. So my dear children, I hope all of you understood the poem. Now we will focus on the difficult words in the present poem. Okay dear, see, lovely. Lovely means very beautiful. Again, buzzing. Buzzing means the humming sound by bees. बेटा आपने सुना होगा हमिंग साउंड, ये जो बजिंग वाला है ये आपने सुना होगा मे बी. द सेकेंड, सॉरी द थर्ड वन, लवली. द थर्ड वर्ड इज स्लीपी हेड. स्लीपी हेड मीन्स अ पर्सन हु वॉन्ट्स टू स्लीप. एंड the last one is the tiniest. Tiniest means smallest. Now children, see here I made few sentences regarding these words, so you can see that how you can use these particular words in the sentences. So the first sentence is lovely. This flower is lovely, means this flower is very beautiful, or this is a lovely flower. Okay, second, buzzing. Bees are buzzing. Okay, the third one, sleepy head. Ram is a sleepy head. And the last one, means the fourth one, tiniest. Ant is the tiniest creature. Creature means beta animal. Okay, now we will focus on our question answers. Now see, reading is fun. Question number one, what do you think birds say to each other in the morning? And the answer is, I think birds say good morning to each other in the morning. Second one, who are already wake up? And the answer is birds, bees, cows, horses, ducks, sheep, sun, trees and chicken are already awake. Dear, here is a print mistake. Chicken are not always, it should be already. Okay, now the next one, which creatures wake up in the morning? B before the child does? And answer is birds, bees, cows, horses, ducks, sheep, chicken wakes up in the morning before the child. Now dear, let's listen. Listen to the songs of birds. Say the words, boy and bee. Listen to the bee sound in, big, bubbles, bin, bag, blue, blow, and black. Dear children, you have to say and you have to listen these words which are going to make the sound B. Again, listen to the baby cheeks. Chip, chip, chip. It's a very simple activity you can do. Now the next, let's listen and talk. Go for a morning walk. Listen to the sounds you hear, like the rustling of leaves, the wind blowing, the chirping of birds, the sounds of footsteps. As you go to morning walk, you can hear these sounds. Okay, so just listen to these sound. Okay, now the second one. Imagine that a cow, a horse, a duck, and a chicken are meeting for a morning meal. What would they say to one another? Talk about it. Children, it's a very funny activity. You just imagine if these animals are going to meet for a morning meal. So what they will talk with each other? Just imagine and try to write in your notebook. Now, say aloud. To this activity, you can say the tongue twister. Okay, I'm going to read it. You listen it carefully. How to pronounce the words. Betty bought a bit of butter, but the bit of butter that Betty bought was bitter. So Betty bought some bitter butter to make the bitter butter better. Okay, and you have, first of all, you have to read it very slowly, and after that try to read it fast. Now see the next activity. Let's write. Connect the pairs of sentences below using and, or, but. Children, in our grammar part, conjunction, I told you how to use these words to connect two sentences. Okay, one example I will tell and the remaining three you have to do. Okay, so see the first one. It is time to get up for school. And the second sentence, I want to sleep for some more time. Now see the sentence or see the answer. It is time to get up for school, but I want to sleep for some more time. So one example I told you, the remaining three you try to make, else we will discuss on these tomorrow. Okay, now dear, see the second question. Fill in the blanks according to the example given below. And yes dear, before starting this poem, I had seen you few videos regarding, yes, comparative and superlative degree. And see, due to this only I had sent you the videos. Okay, due to this activity only. Now see, one example again is given. Tiny, tinier, tiniest. Like that, you just try to do the remaining example. Again, we will discuss on the same tomorrow.